Hello students, I am Rajiv sir. I will be teaching you physics in standard 7B.
Students, I am going to start chapter 2 of the continued part of this chapter. So we first start uniform and non-uniform motion. Uniform and non-uniform motion. First is uniform motion. When an object covers equal distances in equal intervals of time along a straight line, the object is said to be in uniform motion. For example, suppose a body is at A and it starts moving from A to B in 1 second, covering 5 meters, and from B to C in next 1 second is 10 meters. So from A to B taking 1 second, 5 meters, again taking 2 seconds for 10 meters, and from C to D 15 meters, it covers total 15 meters in next 3 seconds. Then the body is said to be in uniform motion. Now second one is non-uniform motion. When an object does not cover equal distances in equal interval of time along a straight line, the object is said to be in non-uniform motion. For example, suppose a body is at point A, it covers 3 meters in 1 second, and from this point B to C covering 5 meters in 2 seconds, and from C to D 10 meters in 3 seconds, then the body is said to be non-uniform motion. Next, distance and displacement. First, distance. The length of the actual path traveled by a moving body in a certain interval of time irrespective of the direction of travel is called distance. For example, suppose a body at point A covers 3 meters and it reaches at B, and then after it start traveling from B to C, next 3 meters, and from C to D it takes 4 meters. Travels 4 meters from C to D. Therefore, total distance covered by the body, covered by the moving body, is equal to AB plus BC plus CD. Magnitude of AB is 3 meters plus BC is 3 meters and CD is 4 meter. Total distance is 10 meter. Next, displacement. The shortest distance between initial and final positions of a moving body is called the displacement. The body. Now SI unit of displacement and distance of displacement and distance both have same unit is meter. Now scalar and vector quantities. Scalar and vector quantities. Scalar, a physical quantity which has magnitude that means size only, not any direction. It's called a scalar quantity. For example, speed, distance, area, etc. Vector quantity, a physical quantity which has both magnitude, size and direction. is called vector quantities. For example, force, velocity, acceleration, displacement, etc. Now, speed and velocity. Speed and velocity. Speed. Distance of a body per unit time is called its speed. SI unit of speed is meter per second. Now velocity. Displacement of a body per unit time is called its velocity. Its SI unit is meter per second. Average speed. The total distance traveled divided by the total time taken gives the average speed. Therefore, average speed is equal to total distance divided by total time taken. Now types of velocity. Types of velocity. Velocity of an object can be categorized into uniform velocity and variable or non-uniform velocity. So, number one, uniform velocity. Uniform velocity. When a body covers equal displacement in equal time interval, then it is said to be moving with uniform velocity. Next, non-uniform velocity or variable velocity. Non-uniform velocity. When a body covers unequal displacements in equal intervals of time, then it is said to be moving with variable or non-uniform velocity. Next, average velocity. Average velocity. When a body moving with variable average velocity can be calculated by dividing total displacement by total time. Taken. Therefore, average velocity is equal to total displacement by total time taken. Next, rest part of this chapter continued in next video. Now, refer to the question which is given on the Tenno app as a homework. Thank you.